Ladies and gentlemen, our next combatant making his way to the blue corner of the ring is also making his Final Fight Championship debut tonight. Representing Italy, please welcome Luca Vitale.
Interesting tattoos.
And his opponent making his way to the red corner, a fighter known for his courage and his never say die attitude. Representing Croatia, please welcome Ivan the Braveheart Gluhak.
Crowd here representing Zagreb, the capital of Croatia, Ivan the Braveheart Gluhak, a well-featured FFC fighter here on the series of Final Fight Championships. We're here at, as I mentioned before, the fabulous city garden, Gradski Vrt in Osijek, Croatia. That's the eastern part of this part of the world. The inventor, the organizer, the promoter, Mr. Orsat Zovko, sat ringside adjacent to me with Marko Petrak, the head supervisor this evening and the matchmaker for all the FFC shows.
Ladies and gentlemen, the next bout consists of three rounds of 5 minutes MMA competition according to Pride rules in the welterweight division. Introducing first, in the blue corner, he weighs in at 75.4 kilograms. He has fought the majority of his fights in his homeland with a record of 4 wins and 3 losses. We're glad to have him here in Osijek tonight, fighting out of Milano, Italy, Luca Vitale. And his opponent in the red corner, he weighs in at 76.9 kilograms. With a record of 9 wins and 6 losses, he always puts up a compelling fight, as I'm sure he will here tonight in the FFC ring. Fighting out of Zagreb, Croatia, Ivan the Braveheart Glua.
So there's the tale of the tape from our man, Peter Linka. This is a welterweight contest. Luca Vitali representing Italy in the blue. Ivan the Braveheart Glua representing Croatia in the red corner, wearing the black shorts. The longer black shorts, should I say? The shorter wrestling tight shorts in the blue corner. The tattooed man from Italy, giving away experience and weight at the scales last night. Straight in for the shoot. Back on the feet very quickly. Fast action from these welterweights. Yeah, as I was saying, the scales last night, if I get a chance to tell you, it could all be over in a blink. Or should I say, don't blink. Luca Vitali tipped the scales 75.4 kilograms and Ivan was 76.9. So he's got a kilo and a half advantage, exactly. He's also got some experience advantage. He's had 9 wins, 6 losses. Taking him to a total of 15. Ooh, nice high kick. Whereas Luca Vitali has only had 7 fights, 4 wins, 3 losses. So he's the underdog here. Saying that, less pressure on the person who's come from the furthest. That's what they say. Inside low kick there coming from Luca. Ivan looking like he's going for the shoot. Faking out the jab. Nice tattoo there on the back of Ivan too. So he's just enjoying the tattoos. For any tattoo lovers out there? Luca going for the shoot and he manages it on the second attempt. Went halfway across ring.
Stop. Center.
Maladen. So he's let go. Claridge, the MMA ref there, bring them back to the center. I mean, going through the ropes.
Fight.
So back into the position in the mount. Ivan on his back. Luca on top.
Nine back hit.
Afraid of a bit of warning there to Luca. The punches coming in from top. Nice hooks going over the top and inside. Takes a nice left hook there. But Ivan is tough, been there before. Ooh, takes a big right. So look at using his head a little bit there. Ivan complaining to the referee. Referee had already spotted it. Watching closely for that. That's about the only thing you can't use in MMA is the head. You can use the head to press with, but you can't use it to strike with. So busy on top. A lot of the techniques have been nullified. Some are getting through. Good body hook, head hook, double hooks coming there from the Italian. Nice right straight, missing with the left. Fighters busy with their arms. Ivan trying to nullify those punches for the ground and pound. Coming by the way of Luca Vitali from Milano. It's the capital of Italy. This is where I'll be tomorrow night. The Legends Show. So many good fights on at the moment, but it's all about these. Fight Channel, FFC. This is where it's at right here, right now. Fabulous shows. We're up to series 11 and many more to go in the future. All around Croatia and the outskirts, Eastern Europe, bringing FFC to the fight fans around the world. And a referee, I think, will be just stopping him there, right above me here.
Stop.
And the head goes between the ropes, and they will reset them. Well, the Italian has been the one who's been putting most of the pressure on.
Fight.
But he stood them back up. So 30 seconds remaining. Luca comes with a knee, and a big punch is coming from Ivan. Luca holds on tight. Ten seconds. The hammer goes down. Ivan using the elbow nicely to push the head to the canvas. Goes the low kick. Blocked on the shin. Well, an interesting first round. To me, the Italian took that first round. A lot more striking. Equal share of the takedowns. But the busier fighter to me was the blue corner. Luca Vitali, the lighter, the less experienced man, has certainly come here to fight tonight in this welterweight contest here in Osijek, Croatia, for the FFC 11. Our lovely ring girls to soften the tone from all that testosterone we have there inside those four ropes. So we see some of that action. Nice slow-mos here from our cameramen. Over the top of that big right. So we've one round in the bag. One third of the fight gone. Two thirds to go. Second round of three. 5 minute rounds.
Time.
5 minutes gone. 10 minutes remaining if it goes the distance. Dan throws the jab. Luca looks above his hands, throws a big right, swings a left and misses. Inside low kick. Right hand coming back from Ivan. Taking on the arms, going for the shoot, going for the double leg takedown. Luca drops his body weight, but he's taken down in his own, taken down his own corner there of Ivan's in the red corner. Oh, nice kicks there, two good kicks to the head. Sees his opportunity and goes for it. Smells blood. It could be over. But he's covering up well. Can he weather the storm? The crowd are behind him. We've seen some daylight. Big kick, two big kicks. Going for the stomp. Dangerous times now for the Italian. He's going to reposition him as the head was going between the ropes. Thought they might have stood them up, but
fight.
They've got in between, they've let him stand and let him lie down.
Stop.
So, yeah, they've stood it up. I think it's going to go nowhere. Good refereeing again. Zlatko Claridge knows his job. Big low kick comes in from the Italian, but he's took some punishment there. But he has managed to weather the storm. Let's see what happens from here. Certainly livened up the crowd here in Osijek. Goes for the shoot. Ivan nullifies that. Nice knee to the head. Blocked on the arm from Luca. The hammer fist goes in, the knees go in.
Are you okay?
He's turning over. I don't know if he's going to stop it. He has. Yeah. Well, what looked like the first round sensation. We thought that Luca Vitali might have had it. But it's not about one. It's about three rounds. And we've seen the first stoppage of the evening. The referee stops it with a technical knockout. In the second round, Ivan, the Braveheart, blue hat. But the man from Milan should not be disappointed. He certainly came here to fight, and he's got a tough, tough head. Took a lot of shots there.
Fighter.
Now you see some of those knees going in from the action where he turned his back, and that to me basically signals it's all over. That's when the referee steps in just shortly after this. There we go. Yeah, seen enough. Great refereeing.
Ladies and gentlemen, at 2 minutes and 15 seconds into round two, the fight has come to an end due to a referee stoppage with punches in favor of the winner, Ivan the Braveheart Gluha.
That takes him to 10 wins. And Luca Vitali, 4 wins, 4 losses. But I certainly came here to fight, having a good first round. Did himself no shame in that first round. He just took a bit of a shot in that corner, in Ivan's corner, and that's when the fight turned itself around.